All right, folks, if you look like me wearing a suit, you're probably a director. And if you're a director, you need to watch this video right now. Hey guys, it's your friendly neighborhood tax man back with another video aimed at helping you navigate the complex world of running a business. In today's video, we're explaining what you need to know about the new director identification rules that the Australian government recently introduced into law to promote the good corporate conduct, tackle illegal Phoenix activity, and prevent fraudulent director identities. If you don't know what illegal Phoenixing is, it's basically when a director liquidates and closes down a company with debt and rebirths it or a similar company with a fresh start, resulting to clearing all their debts and responsibilities. Some directors have been changing their names to make it harder for them to be identified as well. The government has had some troubles, so they've brought in a new way of managing this. This is in the form of Director Identification Number System. A Director Identification Number, DIN, is a unique 15-digit number that will be given to all directors or persons who intend to become directors. This is kind of similar to the Australian Business Number System, but one for directors. Once the Australian Business Registry Services has verified a director's identity, they will be issued the ID number and it will be used to trace a director's relationship to companies. Applications for director ID open from the 1st of November 2021. So here's everything you need to know about who needs to have a director ID, how to apply for one, the penalties you may face for not applying, and how the government intends to use it to combat illegal Phoenix activities. Unfortunately, up until now, directors have been able to falsify their company records by using different names, make it difficult to establish whether directors have been involved in Phoenix activity. By implementing the DIN scheme, the government hopes to get a hold of these Phoenixing activities and prevent it from happening in the future because they can be detrimental to creditors and employees and to the economy overall. So, the director ID will be attached to a director permanently. Even if they stop being a director, change their name, or move interstate or overseas, they will still have the same number. Okay, so now you have basic understanding of what the Director ID initiative is and why it was introduced. Let's take a look at who should apply for one. If you're a director or alternate director acting in the capacity for one of the following entities, you will need to apply for a Director ID number. A company, a registered Australian body, or a registered foreign company under the Corporations Act. You won't need to apply if you're a sole trader, or a partner in a partnership, or a company secretary, or an external company administrator, and if you're a person that is sometimes referred to as a director, but not officially appointed. So basically the people on LinkedIn. You are also excluded from having to register for a director ID if you're a director of a registered charity with an organization type that is not registered with ASIC, or if you're officer of a certain unincorporated association or cooperative or incorporated association. If you fall into the category of directors that need a director ID, the application process is relatively straightforward and it can be completed on the Australian Business Registry Services website. You'll need a MyGov ID to start the application process. You should have that already. And you'll need to provide your residential address as held by the ATO. A tax file number, the information from two documents to verify your ID. These two documents can be either your bank account details, PAYG payment summary, a dividend statement, super account details, or an ATO notice assessment or a Centrelink payment summary. Once the application process is complete and you have received your identification number, you must give the details to the people responsible for maintaining the records for the company. That could be the directors or secretary. Directors under the Corporations Act can start applying for their identification numbers from November 2021. But there are a few deadlines you need to be aware of. Existing directors under the Corporations Act will have a year to apply for their director ID. And new directors appointed between the 1st of November 2021 and the 4th of April 2022 will have 28 days after their appointment to apply for the director ID. New directors appointed from the 5th of April 2022 will be required to apply for their director ID before they are appointed as directors. If you don't apply in time, you could face some pretty hefty penalties, including 5,000 penalty units. Try guessing how much that is. That's $1.11 million. In other words, get the DIN number. The same penalties apply if a director is found guilty of conduct that undermines the new requirements, including providing false identity information to the registrar or intentionally applying for multiple director IDs. So best you get on these registrations as soon as possible. If you have any questions about the application process or the director IDs in general, drop them in the comment section below. Otherwise, remember to hit the thumbs up and subscribe. I'll see you next time.